In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to use your phone while traveling. We'll be going over all the different options, including some basic US carrier international restrictions, including my personal favorite and the one that I use while traveling, a brand new app that lets you install travel eSIMs directly on your phone and use within minutes, and some long-term options if you plan on staying in a specific country for an extended period of time. What is going on, guys? My name is Kyle, and on this channel, I make weekly travel videos ranging from guides, tips, tricks, and even some crazy spontaneous challenges. So if you are into that type of thing, make sure to smash that subscribe button and join me on this crazy adventure. And without further ado, let's jump right into the video. I'll start off by going over some basic international coverage options for some US-based cell carriers. I won't spend too much time on this since I know a lot of you are based outside the US, but I do think it's worth mentioning. Starting with T-Mobile. T-Mobile offers an awesome international plan. They'll give you free unlimited texting, calling at an affordable rate, and unlimited 2G data in over 200 countries, which is more than sufficient for doing basic navigation apps, sending messages in WhatsApp, or maybe even making a quick call in Skype. Verizon has a couple different travel passes that work in over 185 countries. The first one is a travel day pass for $10 per day. And the second is a monthly travel pass for $100 additional to your plan. You can get 1,000 text messages, 250 minutes, and 5 gigs of high-speed data while abroad. Unfortunately, both these options are still outrageously overpriced, and you'd be much better going with one of the options we'll talk about in just a minute. AT&T offers a similar day pass for $10 per day, which will give you service in over 200 plus countries based on your plan that you have back at home. But in my opinion, this is still outrageously overpriced and should never be done, unless maybe you're traveling for business and can just expense it back to your company. In which case, go right ahead. Google Fi is by far the best American-based phone carrier for international travelers. They offer unlimited data and unlimited texting with calling at 20 cents per minute in over 200 countries. This can be especially useful when you just want a dedicated US phone number while traveling or want to be able to easily receive verification codes when logging into different websites. They offer two different plans that have this international coverage. The first one is a flexible plan at $20 per month, which includes unlimited texting and unlimited domestic calling. You'll also get data at $10 per gigabyte with a maximum data charge of $60, meaning after you use 6 gigs of data, the rest of your data for the month is free. The second plan is an unlimited plan. For $70 per month, you get unlimited texting, unlimited domestic calling, and unlimited data. These plans also go down in cost if you have friends or family that you can add to your plan. Unfortunately, I don't have friends, so I have to pay the price for one. Google Fi is great for the international traveler who just wants their phone to work when they arrive in a new country and not have to hassle with getting service set up. I personally love it when I can land in a new airport and just have apps like Rideshare or Navigation work to easily help me get from the airport to my hotel, and having a phone plan that I know my service will work without having to hassle with it. If you do decide to sign up for Google Fi, I would really appreciate if you could use my referral code to get $20 off your first bill and to help support the channel. Google Fi is also zero commitment, so you can cancel anytime you want, or what I love, you can simply pause the service and not get charged, and then resume the service whenever you're ready to get Fi in again. Pausing the service has no penalty to your account, which is why I love to use this feature. I also use the eSIM option. That way, I can keep my SIM card tray empty while traveling, and if I want to, I can put a local SIM card in if I know I'm gonna use a crazy amount of data for whatever reason. Now that we've gone over some basic US international carrier plans, let's talk about what I think is possibly the best option for you if you're traveling abroad and don't necessarily want to change your entire phone plan just for one trip. There's a new app called Airlo, which allows you to purchase a local or regional SIM card if you plan on going to multiple countries directly on your phone and install it within minutes using eSIM technology. What's an eSIM, you may ask? An eSIM is an electric SIM card that you can install super easily within the Airlo app without the need for a physical SIM. Any iPhone past the XR has eSIM technology built in, as well as most modern Android phones. But if you're unsure, you can do a quick Google search to see if your phone is compatible. My friend Alex was topping up his Airlo account recently and was kind enough to screen record it so that way I could show you guys just how easy it is to get your eSIM set up. Simply select what country or region you're going to, select your data package, and then go through the payment process. They even accept Apple Pay, so it makes it super easy and seamless. I do want to mention, these are data-only packages, so you won't get your own dedicated phone number for calling or texting, but you can continue to use iMessage, WhatsApp, and FaceTime audio. I also recommend topping up your Skype account with like $5 in credits. That way, if you want to make any external calls locally, for whatever reason, it's super easy to do. If you do decide to sign up for Airlo, I would really appreciate you using my referral code to get $3 off your first eSIM and to help support the channel. The link will also be down in the description. The final option to get service while traveling is to buy yourself a local SIM card. This can be one of the cheapest options available and is awesome if you plan on staying in one country for an extended period of time. Although I would recommend not purchasing this SIM card in the airport since they will rip you off. Wait until you get into the city, find a reliable phone store, bring your phone in with you, and they can even help you install it. Although for my current travel needs, I definitely prefer to stick to Google Fi since it's so easy to use when switching in between countries. All the recommendations in this video are based on my own travel experience. I am not sponsored or affiliated with any of the companies that we talked about. Any referral codes were simply codes that any user of the app or service are able to get. But these are awesome apps that I really do love to personally use, which is why I wanted to share them with you guys. If you guys got any value from this video, I would really appreciate you smashing that subscribe button and joining me on this crazy adventure. And I will see you guys next week.